Did you know that there are drugs that can slow down the aging process? This is a really big deal, and not just to avoid wrinkles and grey hair. It's because our risk of diseases like cancer, heart disease, and dementia all increase exponentially with age. So what we're talking here is treatments that might be able to slow down or even reverse the aging process itself, delaying many or even all of these diseases, plus frailty, sight, hearing, and memory loss, and even that cosmetic stuff like wrinkles and grey hair, with a single pill. So what kind of pills are we talking about here? There are lots of contenders, but I've narrowed things down to my top five real anti-aging drugs. Let's start with one of the most hyped longevity drugs, rapamycin. Rapamycin was first discovered in bacteria in the soil on Easter Island, which you might know as the one with the massive stone heads, and it's known as Rapa Nui in the local Polynesian. So that's where rapamycin got its name. It's normally used to help transplant patients avoid rejection, as a coating for stents, and as a cancer treatment. But work in the 2000s showed it might be able to do much more than that. It could slow down the aging process itself. The excitement around rapamycin really got going in 2009, when scientists working at the Interventions Testing Program, considered the gold standard for testing longevity drugs in mice, found that rapamycin extended mouse lifespan by 10%. And it's not just mice. We've also got quite a bit of suggestive human data on rapamycin, from over 2 decades of transplant patients and other people using it, and also from some trials looking specifically at its use in aging. One trial of 650 older people showed that a similar drug improved their immunity, and that serious side effects from this kind of treatment are rare. So, what are we waiting for? Should we all be taking rapamycin? Well, unfortunately, although the evidence we have is mostly positive, we don't have the perfect evidence. A nice big randomised clinical trial to tell us one way or the other whether it really improves general health in older people. But there is some good news. That work in mice showed us that rapamycin still works even if given to relatively old mice, roughly equivalent to 60 years old in human terms. So there's no rush for most of us. We've got time to wait for that perfect experiment to come in and tell us one way or the other whether rapamycin really is a longevity drug. Next up, some of the hottest new anti-aging treatments, drugs called senolytics. As we age, lots of things change in our bodies. And one of these is that we accumulate cells that are known as senescent cells. Senescent is just the scientific word for old, and these are cells that have divided too many times, become damaged, and so on. But not only do these senescent cells stop dividing, they also emit a toxic cocktail of molecules that can accelerate loads of aspects of the aging process. But the good news is that scientists have developed drugs called senolytic drugs that can remove these old cells while leaving the rest of the cells of the body intact. In 2018, scientists published a paper where they gave a senolytic cocktail to mice aged 24 months old, which is pretty old for a mouse, and the mice basically got biologically younger. They lived a few months longer, perhaps equivalent to a few years in human terms, but most importantly, they stayed healthier. They delayed diseases like cancer, and they could run further and faster on the tiny mouse-sized treadmills they use in these experiments, a kind of mousy version of delayed frailty. And frankly, the mice just look fantastic. You don't need to be an expert mouse biologist to guess which of these two mice got the drugs. The senolytic cocktail here is known as D plus Q. It's a mixture of dasatinib, a chemotherapy drug, but used at far smaller doses than you use it against cancer. Plus Q, quercetin, a flavanol molecule found in fruit and veg. These weren't picked because they're necessarily the best we could do, but because they're drugs scientists had on their shelves, which, after testing a few dozen, were found to be the most effective at killing senescent cells in a dish. So, if we actively go out hunting for real senolytic drugs, I think we'll be able to find much more effective ones than this first attempt. In fact, 20 or 30 companies are already trying to do just that, with a wide variety of different approaches. So, senolytics certainly seem worth getting a little bit excited about. And that's why they're number 2 on my list of the most promising longevity drugs. Up third, diabetes drug and maybe longevity pill, metformin. If you've read any books about aging biology, or seen much about longevity online, you've probably come across metformin, a diabetes drug that might do far more than keep people's blood sugar under control. The most exciting results came from a study of medical records in the UK, comparing diabetics taking metformin to a control group of patients without diabetes who therefore weren't taking the drug. And they found that people with diabetes outlived the control group. Only by a few months, but given that diabetes usually comes bundled with other health problems, you'd normally expect people with it to survive less long than people without. So the question is, could the metformin have been helping not just with their diabetes, but with other age-related problems like cancer too? What we need is, again, a proper randomised trial. And there's a trial called TAME, or Targeting Ageing with Metformin, that hopes to enlist 3,000 healthy older people and hand out metformin to half of them, but this time at random, rather than just the ones who happen to go on to develop diabetes, and see whether those with metformin or without live longer. Frustratingly, it's been ready to go for quite a few years now, but they can't find the funding. So let's hope that they do find that money soon, and maybe TAME can be the first ever trial of a drug against aging itself. Number four is one I'm newly bullish about, taurine. If you've heard of taurine, it's probably because it's found in energy drinks like Red Bull and Monster. Or because a huge study released in 2023 found that it slowed aging in mice and monkeys. The study authors found that taurine levels decline with age in mice, monkeys, and humans, and that topping up taurine with supplements could make the mice live 10% longer. They also tried giving supplements to monkeys, and though the monkeys did get healthier, it'll be a few more years before we know if they lived longer too. I am possibly running the risk of being a bit zeitgeisty by including taurine, because the study that caused all this excitement came out just a few months ago at the time of recording. But it is quite a solid result, both in terms of mouse lifespan, and it's unusual and pretty cool to have results in monkeys too. It was also a massive study, with 56 authors representing more than a decade of work, both of which make me hope that someone will grab the bull by the horns and run a human trial to find out if taurine can have health benefits for us too. And finally, statins. Statins are another very widely prescribed drug, normally used to reduce levels of cholesterol in your blood and prevent problems like heart attack and stroke. But could they be anti-aging drugs too? I think maybe they could. And the first reason is that their normal function of lowering cholesterol could be described as anti-aging in a way. As time passes, we all accumulate fatty deposits in the walls of our blood vessels. And this process probably starts before we're even born. While you might think of gummed up arteries and heart attacks as something that happens in older people, pathologists have found the early stages of these so-called atherosclerotic plaques in the blood vessels of teenagers who've died from completely unrelated causes like car crashes. Of course, most teenagers, or even most 50-somethings, won't have accumulated enough of these plaques to cause them a heart attack or stroke. But eventually, these buildups can get so big that they can cause serious problems. One way or another, the buildup of cholesterol in the walls of our arteries is responsible for about a third of deaths, both in the rich countries and globally. So this does sound like a cumulative process that could be thought of as part of aging. And statins, by reducing your cholesterol levels, can slow aging down in this way. But they might also have other anti-aging side effects. As we age, immune cells called neutrophils lose their ability to navigate toward danger, and instead take random paths through our tissues that can cause damage that may accelerate aging. And researchers have found that statins can restore these cells' sense of direction. There's also some evidence that statins might increase the length of telomeres, protective caps on the end of our DNA that get shorter as we get older. And statins might even be able to reduce the risk of cancer. A systematic review of 54 statin studies found that they reduced the risk of death from any cause by more than a quarter, which could correspond to maybe a few years of extra healthy life. This could be driven mostly or entirely by the reduction in the risk of heart disease. But it would be cool to see some more research to find out whether statins could have a more general anti-aging effect. All of which is to say, maybe the first anti-aging drugs are with us already. So, Is it time to start popping longevity pills? Well, unless you're advised to take one of these by your doctor for a specific condition, I think most of us would be best advised to watch and wait. We have loads of ideas to slow down or perhaps even reverse aging that work in the lab, be that in cells in a dish or in mice. But which exact drugs will be safest and most effective in humans can only be determined by some proper clinical trials. Given that we've not done these trials, and that there are literally hundreds of drugs which might have an effect on healthy lifespan, you might be wondering how I went about choosing a top five. Well, firstly, this isn't a be-all and end-all list. New evidence, or just a new day of the week, could change what exactly makes it into my shortlist. But there are a few general things to look out for when trying to identify potential promising longevity drugs. Firstly, does it work robustly in mice? The first and best place to check is the Interventions Testing Program, who conduct probably the most rigorous possible tests of longevity drugs. And the ITP has given negative results for some proposed longevity drugs. For example, a lack of effect for a drug called nicotinamide riboside, also known as NR, that supposedly boosts levels of something else called NAD, and some people say might be a longevity drug, is one reason I'm not super excited about NR, NMN, or related compounds. But the ITP also found nothing when they tried a variety of other things which I am more excited about, things like metformin and a couple of statins. And there are some things they haven't tried yet, like taurine. So what if there's no results in mice? Are there results in other organisms commonly used in aging experiments, like flies, worms, or yeast, or indirect results in humans? Now, all of these normally come with pitfalls. For example, in human trials, we don't give drugs for longevity yet, so the results are usually for people with a particular disease, which means they might not generalize to healthy people who are just getting older. So what would make your top five longevity drugs? And are there any in particular you'd like me to look into? Let me know in the comments. And I'll make an update to this video if there are any exciting new developments. So if you enjoyed it, please hit like, and also hit subscribe to be the first to hear when that comes out. In the meantime, check out more longevity science in this video, or you might enjoy my book, Ageless: The New Science of Getting Older Without Getting Old. Click here to find out more.